morning and welcome to your Christmas assembly. For this collective worship, it's not just going to be me on the video this time, but we're going to have a few guests who are going to bring us a quiz and some thoughts about Christmas. Hope you enjoy it.
Hi and welcome to your Christmas quiz. The way you're going to answer is you're going to vote. So either you're going to do thumbs up for true, thumbs down for false, or if it's a multiple choice question, you're going to choose one, two, or three. So, your first question, true or false, the Bible says Mary rode on a donkey. The answer is false. We don't know how they travelled. Question two, which country is St. Nicholas from? One, Finland, two, Greece, or three, Turkey? The correct answer is Turkey, number three. Question three, true or false? The Bible says that three wise men visited Jesus. The answer is false. Jesus was given three gifts, but there is no specific number of wise men mentioned in the Bible. Question four, which country does the Christmas tree originate from? One, Germany, two, Canada, or three, Russia? The answer is number one, Germany. Queen Victoria's husband, Prince Albert, introduced Christmas trees to the UK. And your last question, number five, true or false? The Bible says Jesus was born in December. The answer is false. We don't know the exact date of Jesus' birth. How did you do?
I wonder if any of you remember the Nativity story. It's the Christmas story and it's when Jesus was born into the world. He was born in a stable because there was no room in the inns. There was animals. It was probably dirty. And if you think about it, it was really, really simple. And you know, this Christmas, things are gonna look a little bit different, but we just have to hold on to the simple things, and actually sometimes those simple things are the most important things. Encouraging the ones that you love. So I just want to encourage you that although this Christmas might look a little bit different, it might look really simple and maybe a little bit strange, that actually we can still hold on to those really important things, the things that really matter.
In the Nativity story, when the angel came to visit Mary to tell her that she was going to give birth to a baby, the angel said that the baby will be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. Then when the angels went to tell the shepherds that Jesus had been born, they said that his birth was good news of great joy for all people. Not just some people some of the time, but all people all of the time. The good news of Christmas is that God loved the world so much that he sent his son Jesus. Now, I don't know what Christmas is going to look like for you. I know often when I scroll through Instagram at Christmas, everyone's life looks perfect. perfect Christmas tree in the perfect house with the perfect family and the perfect Christmas dinner and all the perfect presents. Well, let's be honest, no one's life is actually like that. No matter what you see on social media, normal life is messy. Normal life can be tough, even at Christmas. When Jesus was born, he wasn't born into this perfect, tidy Christmas card life. He was born into a real world full of messiness and struggles and brokenness. And his birth is good news of great joy for all people, even in the middle of the mess. And that is good news that we can rely on every single day of the year.
I would like to leave this city. This old town don't smell too pretty. I can feel the warning signs running around my mind. And when I leave this planet, you know I'd stay, but I just can't stand it. And I can feel the warning signs running around my mind. So here I go, I'm still scratching around in the same old hole. My body feels young, but my mind is very old. So what do you say? You can't give me the dreams that ain't mine anyway. You're half a world away. Yeah, you're half.
COVID Christmas. Our Christmases may look a little different this year, but COVID need not dampen our cheer. We can still be kind to each other, write cards that bring smiles, give gifts that bring joy, and see loved ones online without travelling miles. There might not be carol singing or parties, and fewer people around the Christmas table. However, one thing that's the same is the story in the stable of how love came down for the broken and the lost, the creator in creation who paid such a cost. Christmas isn't cancelled this year, all because Jesus can still be found near.